Hello, my name is Tara Rocha. I'm a digital learning specialist at BridgingApps, a program of Easter Seals. In this tutorial, we're going to talk about how to keep kids safe on an iPad or an iPhone. In this day and age, screen time is a pretty big buzzword. If you have an iOS device running iOS 12 or later, you can keep track of how much you use your phone and limit how much you or your kids are using their iPads within the settings of your device, as it is now built right into your iOS software. Screen time does more than limiting time on the mobile device, which can sometimes be confusing. Some of the other great features allow you to make sure your children are safe online, making it possible to keep them off of a particular website or keep them from watching shows meant for other audiences, or even add a filter to limit their music selections. From the Settings app, you will scroll down to Screen Time with the purple icon next to it. If you have set up Screen Time for other people in your home through family sharing, you will see them at the bottom in the family section. If you already have Screen Time set up, you're going to open your Settings application and then tap Screen Time. At the top, you can see a general graph of my usage for today, and it's divided up into categories. If you don't see this, it's because you haven't set up Screen Time.
Or it's because Screen Time is turned off and you need to turn it back on.
The first time you open Screen Time, it will explain the features, and your screen will look something like this. It will walk you through the setup process, and it'll ask you if the device you are working on is for yourself or for a child. Believe it or not, some parents and adults like to set screen time up for themselves to help them find a balance for their own social media accounts and other apps. You can then set up something called downtime. Downtime allows you to choose times when your child will not be allowed to access the iPad or iPhone. You can choose to still allow messages, calls, or other apps during this time. App limits can be set for an entire category or for only particular apps. You can decide, for example, that your child can only access social networking apps for 1 hour per day. You can also create a screen time passcode. Keep in mind that this is different from the passcode that controls the whole device. This is important so that your child cannot access the settings and change them.
For the next section in screen time, we're going to look at content and privacy restrictions.
This screen will introduce you to the features to restrict content and privacy settings. You can choose the highest rating of a movie that your child is allowed to watch, for example. When you see this screen, after setting up your passcode, choose Content and Privacy Restrictions so that you can begin choosing the appropriate settings for your child. You must first toggle the Content and Privacy Restrictions button to allow access to the individual settings. Then click on Content Restriction. Below Content and Privacy Options, you also have Privacy and Allow Changes. These refer to public sharing of location and also what changes your child is allowed to make to the device. There's even a Share Across Devices section. So if you have other devices signed into iCloud, it'll then combine all the screen time between all those applications and devices and then give you that data based on that as well. You can set it up for your family as well, so this way you can view your child's screen time reports and parental controls. If you've never actually turned on screen time for your own device, you can do that too by tapping on the words Turn on Screen Time. This will give you a weekly report with insights about your screen time and set time limits for apps you want to manage. You will start being able to see a graph with more details. At the top, you'll notice you can see today, as well as details for the other 6 days in the week.
we're going to focus on today, but everything I show you for the today section, you can also see the same information for the last several days. Once you open up the days, the screen time graph is now broken down into time slots. If you tap on any section of the graph, you can see this time slot with the amount of time you were using in between those hours. If you scroll down a little bit more, there's a section called pickups. This is really neat because it tells you how often you pick up your phone between certain hours. You can see which times of the day you have the most pickups. You can also get an idea of how many notifications you receive per hour, which is sometimes why we pick up our phone. From this screen, you can also see which applications are sending you notifications, and you can then go into your notification settings where you can turn them off and on and play around with the way you see it. So if it shows up on your lock screen, or if you see it in the notification center, or if you're going to see the banner that pulls down from the top. If you're setting screen time up on your own device, once you've used all of your time, you will get a message on your device with some options to choose from. 1 more minute, remind me in 15 minutes, ignore time limit for today, or choose cancel, and you will be locked out of that app for the rest of the day. If screen time is set up on another family member's device, they will get a message saying that they've reached their limit for the day. And from their device, you can enter more time, or they can send a request to get more time. If they press cancel, they'll be locked out of that app for the rest of the day. In our work at Bridging Apps and working with our special needs populations, we have many students who are transitioning from childhood to adulthood. Several of the families that we've been working with have set up these screen time limits on their teenage kids' phones, and they've told us how it truly helps them focus. As we worked in one transition classroom, a young man whose parents had a pretty good handle on technology and how it affected their son's learning set up screen time limits for some of his favorite apps like Smool and karaoke or race car driving games because that's what he wanted to do. But because they wanted him to focus on his tasks at hand, they also realized that they wanted him to have a phone to be able to communicate and connect with his friends. So setting up these restrictions allowed him to learn that there's a time and a place for everything. After his studies and work, he's able to go onto his phone and play the apps that he wants to, since he also has that downtime feature set up on his device. During different parts of our kids' days, there's definitely downtime. And in some classrooms, teachers allow their students to get on their phones. In other classrooms, they cannot. But giving our kids free rein on these devices makes it difficult for even adults to focus. And when we realize what we allow them to see gives us the power in controlling what they can and can't have access to, it makes our kids safer.